We will move on the first database from which different compounds or ligand can be collected. You can say PubChem. This is a freely accessible database from which different compounds can be collected for the multiple docking and multiple dynamic simulation, and related to them publications available and their functions also available in this database. So I will write any ID. You can retrieve the compound by ID or by any name, like aspirin. I will click on the aspirin. There will be different compounds. This is the aspirin, and we can choose this aspirin for the multiple docking, and we randomly pick any protein from the PDB database from for the multiple docking. And we will click on this. This is the aspirin and its molecular weight, aspirin name, and its synonym, and you can say, you can see molecular weight and its date of publication in the database, and its function also available here, and structure available, 2D structure. This is its 2D structure, and 3D conformer. This is the 3D structure of it. So we always need 3D structure of the compound for the multiple docking. And here we will move on the download, and we'll save the structure in SDF format. So we will move to download. It is giving error. Why? So this structure has been downloaded now, and we will move this structure has been downloaded in SDF format, and now we will convert it into a 3D so a 3D structure or 3D format into PDB format, so that we can do docking very easily. So we can open it into Chimera. We will search for the Chimera is a software. This 2D structure can be opened in Maestro Schrodinger also. So we can easily open it in Schrodinger for the converting it into PDB format. So it is starting now. It is taking time due to the less computational power, and because this software is very much heavy and takes some time, will take some time to start. Okay. software has been started, and this is the structure of the compound aspirin, and we will use this structure for the molecular docking with our protein, and the protein will be collected from the protein data bank PDB. So this structure can be saved as export structure. We will go towards export, and on that we will save it on desktop, and here we will keep its name ligand.pdb. Here, from here we can move select the extension. This is our PDB structure, will be saved on desktop. The structure has been saved. This is the structure that we saved from the dashboard, and now we'll move on PDB database to collect our protein. This is the home page of the PDB database, and from here we will write any protein name, but I will write COVID-19 protein 6LU7. This is the protein 6LU7 that is present in the COVID virus. So we will while we are downloading the protein for the molecular docking, we see the resolution power. Resolution, this is 2.16 angstrom, and this should be less than 3, or if this will be less than 2, that will be great. So we will move download now into PDB format. So it has been downloaded now. This is the protein and this is the ligand. Before docking, we always minimize the structure of the ligand as well as protein. So if we are talking about the protein minimization, we will then again move towards the Desmond Maestro to minimize our protein structure, and again we will minimize the ligand structure, but due to less time we will move without minimization. And tomorrow when we will start the MD simulation, I will tell you about the minimization process, and both files will be minimized. So you will be able to learn the minimization process, and you can apply that process before the molecular docking also. So we will open the Pyrex software. Sorry, in this laptop Pyrex is not available. I will install now in front of you. This is the Pyrex website, and we will choose the freely version of the Pyrex. Just click on the choose. and download. Firex is being downloaded and click on download. This will take 1 to 2 minutes only because internet speed is faster. Okay, we have our Pyrex setup and we will install this. You can consider that we have downloaded the Pyrex and double click on the Pyrex. Click on yes. On the next, and this will be click on again next, and this will be installed. So Pyrex has been installed now, and we will finish this. Okay. This Pyrex icon has been shown, and Pyrex automatically opening now. As I already told you about the docking, there are two types of the docking, docking and targeting docking. Client docking, you don't have any information about your about the active site protein, and you do client docking while software automatically detected its binding pocket. On the other hand, in targeting, we already known about the active site of the protein, and we already know about the function of that active site, and on that specific active site we will dock the compound of any compound that is specific to stop the activity of the protein or to stop the activity of diseased protein. So this is the software that we have installed now, and we will do docking on this. Types of docking will be performed on this software, and after that we will perform the multiple docking on the AutoDock Core, and this results has been accepted. The results of this software have been accepted in many publications, and there are two my research articles that has been accepted in journals for the publication. And I performed docking using this software also. So we will click on the Vena wizard and click on the start. This has been showed in screen that this is the ligand molecule box and this is the macromolecule. In ligand box, we will import the compound that we from the PubChem. And this is the macromolecule.
Excuse me.
We'll import the receptor or our diseased protein that we already downloaded from the protein data bank.
Meri awaaz aa rahi hai, excuse me.
First of all, we will click on add ligand because we need ligand to dock on the protein. So this is the option. We click on the add ligand. Note all. This is the desktop, and here all the PDB structures are available. And as we clicked on the ligand, and we will import the ligand for the docking on the protein or receptors. And this is the ligand, and we will click on this. Open. This is the ligand that has been opened and automatically converted into PDBQT file. PDBQT file is very necessary for the molecular docking because from this file, further process of the docking will be run. And after loading the this ligand molecule, we will click on the add macromolecule and import the protein structure that we have for the docking. So the protein structure also has been downloaded and imported into this box, into macromolecule box. And now we will move on the molecule docking. You can see here that structure is not showing in this box because this is we can say that this is the error, and if this error has come, you can cross this software and you can turn off the software, and again you will start the software and it will be correctly will do the docking. So again we will open the Pyrex software. Click on the Vena wizard and start. If we click on this, no. So again, add macromolecule. Sorry, add ligand. Desktop. This is ligand. And add macromolecule. 6 LU7. So this is the structure that we wanted. The structure has successfully imported in the macromolecule box, and ligand also has been imported in the ligand molecule box. So first of all, we will do the blind docking because we don't know about the active site at this time. We consider this, we don't know the active site of the protein. No doubt we know about the active site of this protein, but still we will say that we don't know because we want blind docking. So this is very simple and very easy. Click on this protein and click on this ligand, click on forward. So this is the box that already been there, and we can show the full screen. This is the full screen. Using this box and using blind docking, we will cover all protein. We will cover whole protein into this box for the blind docking. This is the ligand that is near to the protein. We are going to do blind docking, and we can see on the 3D dimension that everything is covered. This is the disulfide bridge. Before docking, we can remove it using the chimera, but no problem. If we will not remove it, it will not affect the results of the docking. So we covered all protein and we'll click on the forward. This is the exhaustiveness value. This means that how much you want your compound will be a move from one place to another place. So this is the by default value that is good, and we always use this value and click on forward. This will take 1 or 2 minutes. Docking has been completed, blind docking has been completed, and this is showing that your binding affinity, binding energy is minus 5.6 and minimum should be minus 5 or 6. And I think it is good energy and can be acceptable. And after the simulation results, it is more acceptable in the publications. So we can say that this has been, the docking has been completed now. Now we will move towards making the complex of the protein ligand complex, and then we will see the interactions of the protein ligand complex. And after that, we will do the targeting docking because this protein has active site that is known. So after this session, because 7 minutes are remaining, and our analysis will not be completed. After 10 minutes, we will move towards the targeting docking and as well as active, as well as the interaction analysis. So this is the docking that is, that has been completed. If anyone has the question, has query, you can ask.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Okay, like Sir Usman told you about the question is arised that how may we know this ligand is suitable for our protein? Okay, there are pre-process, there are different, you can say analysis before docking. You can use ADMET analysis. No, no, Schrodinger is not must. So I will answer the question. No, before the docking, protein ligand and protein minimization is very necessary before docking. If we will not minimize it, results can be affected, but